Hello everybody, my name is Rama Tandon and I'm a dyslexia therapist. I work with children with learning difficulties and disabilities like dyslexia, dysgraphia, etc. Many parents and teachers don't fully understand dyslexia and they do not know how to identify these students in the classroom or at home. What should they do about it? What I did was, since elections is in less than a week in Delhi here, I thought of giving a written assignment to my students. If I was the Prime Minister of India, they had to write just 4-5 lines on this. Now, if you see this child here started writing, if I was the Prime Minister of India, I would tell whole India, and then he stopped because he realized he was making some spelling errors. For example, would is spelled as WOOD. Instead of WOULD, whole is spelled as HOLE instead of WHOLE. So I asked him to stop and I said, it's okay, let me write it for you. You just tell me whatever is on your mind. And we had a little discussion before I started writing. Children with dyslexia are amazing. They have amazing creativity and leadership skills. And you'll be shocked and happy to know that the answers, the thoughts that were on the mind of this child was amazing. He talked about having a house for all the dogs on the street. He talked about saving the trees. And he was just talking and talking and talking. Now what happens at home or in classroom situation, when the children are given any written assignment, the parents or teachers very often, parents, they look at the spellings and then they start yelling at the child and saying, my God, you've got so many mistakes here, and overlooking actually the content, which is actually should be the main focus. I request all the parents when they're giving written exercise as such, please do not look at the spellings. Do not tell them that this is wrong and that is wrong. Look at the content. Look at what he's written or what he's trying to write. Talk to him, talk to the child, discuss whatever is on his mind. If you want to concentrate on spellings, which is another skill totally, then there is dictation. You can give him dictation of a paragraph or words. But this was just a written exercise. There's another child who was writing, and this child has dysgraphia. And you will notice that every child had to write how old they were. So he's written his age as age 3 months away from being 10. I thought that was a very wonderful and a unique way of telling how old are you. Children with dyslexia, dysgraphia, they have a very hard time transmitting their thoughts on paper. So try to be patient with them and try to understand what they have on their mind. Despite their struggles with spellings and reading, people like John F. Kennedy, George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, they could become the President of United States of America. So I actually feel that there's a high possibility that 30 years, 40 years from now, maybe one of my students can become the President or the Prime Minister of India. You never know. I hope this video was helpful, and please do share this video with people and children and teachers and parents who can benefit from this. Subscribe to my channel and share your comments, and please wait for my video next week. I'll come up with something different. Thank you very much.